हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर तुषार गुजराती फ्रॉम S&T कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड रिसर्च सेंटर येवला। टुडे विल स्टडी वन मोर प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन रिडक्शन ऑफ ब्लॉक डायग्राम्स इन डिटेल। ओके, सो द क्वेश्चन इज सिंप्लीफाई द ब्लॉक डायग्राम देन ऑब्टेन द क्लोज लूप ट्रांसफर फंक्शन सी ऑफ एस अपॉन आर ऑफ एस। ओके, नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज इन डिफरेंट मैनर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट क्लोज लूप ट्रांसफर फंक्शन सी ऑफ एस अपॉन आर ऑफ एस। It is C of S is here output and R of S is input. The ratio of output and input is called as transfer function. So in this case, we have to find out closed loop transfer function. So for finding out this closed loop transfer function, we have to reduce this block diagram to only one block. So we can reduce this block diagram up to only one block with the help of reduction rules. Okay, so what is written here? First, move the branch point between G3 and G4 to the right hand side of the loop, okay, containing G3, G4 and S2. Then move the summing point between G1 and G2 to the left hand side of the first summing point. Okay, so what we have to do here, we have to move this towards this side and this summing point towards this side. Okay, so like this we have to perform the operations. So we have to move here summing point and take up point. Okay, so after moving this summing point and take up point, the diagram gets simplified something like this. So what we have done here, we have moved this point over here. Okay, so the block crossed here is G4. G4 is crossed, that's why we have added here S3 upon G4, okay, in parallel. Similarly, this summing point is shifted over here, so we have crossed G1. Now G1 block is crossed, that's why we have added here 1 upon G1. So this you remember. So when we cross some block, at the time we have to add its reciprocal or that block as per our rule. Okay, so now the problem is simplified. If you see, we got two feedback loops. So this is one feedback loop over here and this is another feedback loop. So these two feedback loops we can solve very easily with the help of feedback loop formulas. Okay, so after solving the feedback loops, we get such answers. So this is our first answer, this is second answer, and upper terms are multiplied because upper blocks are in series. So we get S3 upon G1, G4. Okay, this is our input, this is our output. Now in the next step, what we can do? We can multiply these two blocks. Okay, these two blocks can be multiplied because they are in series, and this upper block is in feedback loop. This is feedback loop. Okay, so we have to use again feedback loop formula, and then we have to solve this. Then we get final answer as input is R of S, output is C of S. Okay, so like this we can solve or simplify such a problems. So here output upon input, that is CS divided by R of S, is equal to the transfer function which we got in the last block. This is called as the closed loop transfer function of the system, C of S upon R of S. Okay, now we'll reduce another block diagram. So here in this case the block diagram is as shown in figure. Okay, so you try to understand or you check what we can do in first step. You try to memorize this, what we can do in first step. You just try to understand the problem from where we can start. Okay, so we'll go step by step now. So in the first step, we are going to move the summing points ahead of block G1. So now in this case, this summing point is shifted towards here ahead of block G1. Okay, because we cannot take this G1 and G2 in series. So if we want to take G1 and G2 into series, then we have to move the summing points ahead of this block g1. Okay. So now after taking the summing points ahead of log g1, what will happen? We have to add that reciprocal of g1 in the parallel. Okay. So here the block becomes h2 upon g1, because we have crossed to this g1. That's why we have to add here 1 upon g1. Now you can see that these two blocks are in series, g1 and g2. So you can multiply those blocks very easily. Okay, that's why we got the answer as g1 into g2. Okay, now what you can do in next step, okay, what you can do, you can switch the summing points. Okay, now here you check the two summing points are present, this is summing point and this is summing point. So because of this summing point, actually we cannot solve the feedback loops. If we switch their position, this can be shifted to this, at the time there will be some simplification. So now we just check how the blocks are shifted. Okay, so previously h1 was towards left side, now h1 is on right hand side. Okay, so now we got one feedback loop, simplified feedback loop. So this is one feedback loop, this we can solve very easily by using formulas. Okay, so after solving this feedback loop, we got this term g1 g2 divided by 1 minus g1 g2 h1. This is our one term. Now again these two blocks are in series. Okay, if these are in series, we have to multiply. Okay, so after multiplication we got one block, that is g1 g2 g3 divided by 1 minus g1 g2 h1. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to again solve this feedback loop. So this is feedback path and this is forward path. So we have to solve this feedback loop, and here it is negative sign present, so we have to use positive sign in the formula. Negative feedback loop is present, that's why we can use in the formula positive sign. Now after solving the feedback loop, we got such an answer: g1 g2 g3 divided by 1 minus g1 g2 h1 plus g2 g3 h2. Now at the end we got only one feedback loop, and which is negative feedback loop. Okay, so if nothing is written over here, you can write one also as it is. Okay, now you have to solve this feedback loop. After solving this feedback loop, you will get this answer: g1 g2 g3 divided by 1 minus g1 g2 h1 plus g2 g3 h2 plus g1 g2 g3. Okay, and only one input and only one output. Okay, so like this we have solved the block diagram. So now one more question is shown over here: find the transfer function of the following block diagrams. So how will you solve this block diagram? So solution is provided over here. So what you can do, you eliminate loop 1. Okay, so this is loop number 1 that you can eliminate. So that is negative feedback loop, and that you can solve very easily. So after solving this, you will get such an answer: g2 upon 1 plus g2 s2. So this is the answer of first feedback loop. Now you move the pickup point A behind a block g2 upon 1 plus g2 s2, means you have to move these pickup points towards here. Okay, now here you have to use the formula of pickup point. So when you are shifting that pickup point towards right side, at the time you have to add reciprocal of that block in the parallel. So here in the parallel we have added reciprocal of this entire block. So 1 upon g2 s2 divided by g2, this is reciprocal we have added. Okay, now what you can do for solving, now you solve this another feedback loop number 2. Okay, so in this upper two blocks are in series, so you multiply those blocks, and lower block, that is S3, is in feedback part, so that you can solve very easily. So but you see here, just I told you this is feedback loop, but you check here summing point. So this summing point has both the arrows coming towards it. Okay, so there is no feedback part actually, both are in parallel, both the arrows are in parallel, they are coming towards that swimming point. Okay, that's why it is not a feedback loop, but it is parallel loop. So you have to take both the lines in parallel. Okay, so that's why we are going to add. So H3 plus H1 into 1 plus G2 H2 divided by G2. So like this we can add both the lines. Now eliminate loop number 2. Now this loop number 2 we can eliminate very easily by using feedback loop formulas, and at the end we will get this answer, output upon input, that is y of s upon r of s is equal to this entire